Mickey D'Amato wants to compete next year with.
Ooh.
I guess if you have a foot finish, that's the place to be.
Everyone kind of just went,
yeah.
All righty.
Little muscle pull there for you.
No jams in the forecast.
Yeah.
Very nice. Very nice. You know what? We don't have any sign of any kind of rain or clouds or anything for us today. Since about 5 o'clock last night, the only sign of precipitation in the southern part of the state. And even there, things have cleared out nicely. So we're looking good today up to about 75.
All right. Thank
you. Guys have worked it on your toe recently, too, so I hope it's back in fighting form.
Thanks.
Huh?
Yeah, it's doing just fine.
Well, good. Glad to hear that. Thanks for joining us on this Monday morning. We'll be here all morning long with news, traffic, and weather updates.
And please join us for Channel 3 News at noon. Next, it's Today in Cleveland with those two sweetie pies, Tom and Dell. Let's see what they're cooking.
Check it out, only four more, check him out. Put him on your VCR. Good morning, everybody. Welcome to the breakfast table. It is Monday morning.
Oh, God, it feels like it.
Top it does, doesn't
to
it?
You. He's Del, I'm Tom. Here's Henry.
And as you slide up the breakfast table, Eddie Bell and I were in Minerva in Carrollton Saturday doing Adele's folks' travel story. The folks were wonderful to us. They sent you a nice, nice card, a key to the city, some Wright brand golf balls and hats. I tell you, they were so good to us.
In the right
you,
time.
Carrollton and Minerva. Wonderful.
This is the key to Carrollton?
That's the key to Minerva.
Oh, Minerva.
You know, Twyla Karman's hometown.
Yeah, oh, of course I do. And I thank you very much. I have a lot of time. I'll go down and try the ski. What are you sticking in?
I told him, I said, anybody want anything in Minerva? We have the key. Nice, nice folks. Thank you. And thank you, Ms. Markley.
Thank you very much. Annie Doherty down in Akron sent up one of the most terrible jokes that we ever did. The woman goes to her doctor and she has a complete physical. And the doctor starts writing out the prescription. He said, now here's what you do. He said, take this green pill with a glass of water when you get up. And the woman looks at the doctor. And he said, now, take this yellow one with a glass of water just before you have lunch. She said, okay. And then he said, finally, take this red one with a glass of water just before you go to sleep. She said, well, doctor, exactly what do I have? He said, you don't drink enough water. I don't remember that one.
Yeah, you had to revive that one, didn't you? Okay. Let's check out the headlines this morning. A plane hijacking in Germany is over with nobody hurt. Police games for meaningful causes underway in Cleveland. The Indians had a blowout Sunday in Boston, losing only 12-6. They still lead the Central Division by 2.5 games. Oh, what's his name here is going to open the mail bag.
And I want some time for that. We got some pretty good letters.
Okay, and on this date in history, 1940... Norway surrendered to the Nazis during World War II, and in 1973, Secretariat became horse racing's first Triple Crown winner in 25 years by winning the Belmont Stakes. And Corker Tom's in the news this morning with a little bonus for you.
No kidding.
Yeah, I'll tell you.
You know, I stepped out this morning, there were enough stars for everyone. Oh, boy. And it felt like a summer morning. Coming up the hill, I didn't even feel a breath of air. Not a you-know-what was out of place. And can you believe this? Over the weekend, they put in the new flagpole at the Federal Building. They did it just for me for this week. And so I think that's very thoughtful.
So you can fight the federal government and they will respond.
Down there this morning, it's a 5-iron and a 4-iron, 54 degrees. And it looks good.
And speaking of that, the last installment of Ollie Hassenflew's 745 Bay Presbyterian Donuts.
You know, like ordinary people, I'm going to have to start buying golf balls. That's going to be hard on my heart.
If you call Ollie once in a while, he'll still supply them. You know that generous man that
he will.
Okay, over whatever it is you're having for breakfast, and we're having Ollie's donuts and some candy a little later. Candy Stokes, 48 degrees and beautiful out there at the Can Do It Farm in Ashtabula County, and she's training camp counselors today. Ella Rohr, God love her, we love her. 52 degrees on the potato farm down there in Wayne County. Millie, 54, on the Big Prairie in Holmes County, and she's going to pull weeds out of the garden today. Paul, 43 degrees in Sagamore Hills, and he said the sun was peeking through the leafy ash tree. Mike and Mary, 51 degrees and calm around their beautiful North Ridgeville home. Joanne, 50 degrees in Reading, Pennsylvania, not at Field School. School's out.
She called you from there?
She is headed to New Jersey for the summer.
Well, she's not cheap.
And let's see. At the East Side Cafe, Jimmy looked out the window and he saw 59 degrees. And now, Tammy, come back to me, will you? Because I want to give him the menu. Tammy Morris is the pride of Vermilion, bossing us around today. Jimmy says they're having tangy, tender baked potatoes and creamy homemade pea salad for lunch.
Yeah, I think he calls that his tum special. That's a honey. Hey, we're at 6:35 at the breakfast table. A peek at our exclusive Instant Doppler 3 radar. No reason at all to look at it. And the weather's kind of simple. What's today like? Well, today's going to be, we're going to have a mostly sunny sky. Who can kick about that? We'll be up to 75 degrees. Winds will come out of the north at 5 to 10. You'll hardly even notice them. Tonight, it'll be clear. Well, that means we'll have a lot of stars up there. Low tonight, about 55. And the winds will be light and variable. And then tomorrow, guess what? Just one other sunny day, warmer. And tomorrow's high, 81 degrees. I can handle that. That's it.
Getting a little too warm for me. Yeah, dingy the bell.
Little too warm?
Yeah.
Right, you're out of your hat. There we go.
I'm in my hat from Minerva Cheese Company, and yours is from the Lion Den Sports Shop. They call their teams in Minerva the Lions.
Do they really?
And it's cute. All the way the street leading to the stadium, they have these big lion paws painted on the street. They're there the year round. Nice folks.
Don't take a lot to excite you, does it?
No, we had a good time in Carrollton and in Minerva. Wonderful. RTA trains and buses out and around on time. Let's keep it that way. Just keep your speed down in the construction zones. Watch out for the workers and the yellow barrels or the orange barrels. You should be okay on a Monday.
Yeah, I gave you some easy ones here from Jill Sells, Cleveland Trivia, Quizbook Delvert. And we start with the first one here this morning. The question, name the blue-eyed movie star and spaghetti sauce maker who was raised in Shaker Heights. Everyone knows that.
Yeah.
Who was it?
Oh, you know. Newman. Paul Newman.
Right. Amen and hallelujah. How about this one, since you do all those food things? Peanut butter and onion burgers are a house specialty at what West Side restaurant?
I'll say, I know, Bearden's.
That's right.
Of
course.
It's
won all sort of awards. You're pretty good.
And I did a Dell's Folks Feast there.
I think it's exactly what I just said. Hey, and this one right here. A sleeping mama cat and her kittens were the mascots of what railroad system that used to be headquartered here in Cleveland?
Chessie.
Oh, man, that Moravia education, I just can't keep up with.
Remember that little kitten?
Chesapeake in Ohio.
Yeah.
Back in a moment, 6:37 at the breakfast table, Delbert gets himself to the news. It's June 9th, 1997, and there's Mike Diabato. Look at him. Working there, he doesn't know where his elbow is. Is that Mike?
Channel 3 News is sponsored by The Plain Dealer. News from around the world and around the corner.
Tell it like it is.
These are your storytellers.
Tell it like it is.
Every day they write it like they see it in the pages of The Plain Dealer. You wouldn't want it any other way. So find out what's really going on.
Tell it like it is.
Pick up The Plain Dealer today, or to start home delivery, call 1-800-231-8200.
Right now, there's three ways to save on America's best-selling full-size car. 1,000 cash, super low-rate financing way below prime, or this incredible family-friendly lease. Hey, you're gonna love your new LeSabre.
So come on in.
Driving your new Buick, you're gonna be turning it.
Lots of people think they can't get their prescriptions put into the sunglass styles they really want. But at Lens Crafters, we have these sun centers. Whether you need regular or prescription sunglasses, we have great styles, great prices. We've got Ray-Ban, Anne Klein, Vogue, hundreds of pairs. And we can put prescriptions into almost all of them. All the latest fashions. We're Lens Crafters. The glasses are ready in about an hour, and my customers go home happy. I love what I do. I help people see better.
The Prescription Sunglass Event, now at Lens Crafters.
Hi, come up, boy. Hey, kids, who wants some Edie's ice cream?
Edie's cookie dough with real cookie dough. What could be better?
Stock up on Edie's for your picnics and parties. Discount Drug Mart carries a full line of delicious Edie's ice cream and frozen yogurt. From Rocky Road to Vanilla, you'll find something to please everyone in your family.
You'll find everything you need.
There's a new magazine that promises natural beauties instead of silicone cuties. Look out, Playboy. They're perfect tens. On our copy.
Monday night at 7 on Channel 3.
Well, Del, but who are those people?
Well, handsome people. Mike D'Amato.
Who's working on camera this
That's
morning.
Right. He was shooting on the street then, and we were in Minerva, and that is the late and the lovely, wonderful Twyla Carmen, the voice of Minerva so many years on the radio.
Oh, who you just mentioned a moment ago.
That's right.
And we were showing Michael Gage before, and with the lights in my eyes, I really couldn't tell what we were shooting. I saw Mike, and I thought he was getting himself on camera.
Michael Gage is the maestro of the control world.
He does a heck of a job, and it's nice to have him. Hey, I got this in the mail this morning from MJI?
Yeah, 105.7.
Chris Quinn, who's the evening personality there, and he took two things. I'm not going to show them on camera. One was an ad for Morning Surprise that was in the Plain Dealer on Thursday, July 7th, 1956.
That was your show, wasn't it?
Yeah, I did it. And Jay Milton was Mr. Rivets. And the other one was from the radio TV editor George Condon 41 years ago. It was on the 6th. When he printed a whole story on the show and on me, and he said, this is for your scrapbook. But he added something in it. He said, you remember that 105.7 is your old FM station at KYW-FM. I didn't even know that.
I didn't know that.
So I said, we learn something new every day.
And, you know, every place I go, people say, remember that show that Tom used to do? The memories are going to last forever and ever, Mr. Haley.
I will pass with no comment.
Okay, now, but we will pay attention to this harness racing news. Corker Tom, his horse, handled by veteran harness race driver Don McKergan, battled his way to a strong second place finish last evening at Northfield Park. Corker Tom paid $6.20 place money to $4.40 to show. Time for the mile, 23.4 seconds.
So this is $21.20. Is this for me?
Well, it says some of it's for me, but I give it to you because it's your horse.
You don't get anything out of it. Are you crazy? Hey, that's most money ever made on this show.
And Betty and Nick Rock sent you some...
Well, bless their hearts.
Koblenz Candy Company down in Walnut Creek.
Thanks, Betty and Nick.
Okay.
Oh, man.
Sorry,
in a fancy place.
Sorry, Betty, that I messed up the time and all that. But you know, I'm not into horse racing, but Corker Tom is. Okay, let's get to the news. In the world and national news at Cologne, Germany today, two hijackers who had been holding an Air Malta jetliner surrendered early this morning. Authorities say the hijackers had demanded freedom for the Turkish man who shot Pope John Paul II in 1981. None of the 80 passengers nor crew members on the jet was hurt. In Denver, defense attorneys for Timothy McVeigh will resume their effort this morning to save him from the death penalty. They'll be calling members of his family, his former teachers and friends, to the witness stand. The lawyers hope to persuade the jury to spare McVeigh's life after his conviction for the Oklahoma City bombing. The Today Show, of course, will have much more beginning at 7 o'clock. In area news, Elyria police are investigating the shooting death of a 22-year-old man. They say two teenagers were with him at the time of the shooting, and it's possible they were playing Russian roulette. The name of the victim is being withheld pending notification of his family. Funeral services will be held this morning for 12-year-old Precious Howard, the Maple Heights girl struck and killed by a car as she was going to school last Wednesday morning. She was fatally injured while trying to cross Warrensville Center Road. Authorities say she apparently panicked and was trying to turn back when she was hit by the oncoming van. The driver wasn't charged. Cleveland police are still trying to identify the body of a man found on Cleveland's east side. The body was found Saturday night in an alley near East 116th and Kinsman. Authorities say the man had apparently been strangled, believe the body was placed in the alley only hours before it was discovered by some residents of the neighborhood. Police are treating the death as a homicide. Ravenna fire authorities continue their investigation of the fire early yesterday morning that destroyed a landmark building on the city's Hazen Street. The 100-year-old industrial building used to house the A.C. Williams Company and is currently owned by Storman Marketing. Investigators who believe this may be an arson case say it could be a couple of weeks before the investigation is completed. The city of Cleveland is playing host this week to the 20th annual Law Enforcement Games. The games were kicked off yesterday with a special service at the Police Memorial Wall. More than 1,800 police officers from around the state are in the city to take part in more than 30 events, all designed to promote teamwork and fitness. And so we welcome the men in blue. Now,
there was 35 mil in Super Lotto on Saturday night. I checked my ticket this morning. I had six, the first number. That was it.
All right.
So what happened? 35 mil were there. Maybe you've already heard there were two big winners in Saturday night's $35 million Super Lotto. Two of them had all these numbers, 6, 14, 27, 32, 36, and 41. It was purchased at Forest Hills Eagle in East Cleveland and the other at Uptown Market in Toledo. And one of the winners chose 26 yearly payments worth $17.5 million. The other, a lump sum of $7.8 million before state and federal taxes.
Not bad pocket change.
I can't believe that they'd take all that money. And there was a kicker winner on Saturday night, and now the lottery has gone out of business because they're flat dead broke.
That's don't it. You count on it. My mug, by the way, is from Brown's Flowers and Gifts and Home Decor in Minerva. Little old train shown there. That's nice. And it holds Martha's coffee just fine. Okay, quickly in sports and then the mailbag.
No,
we got greetings.
Social notes.
Finally, I'll get onto the routine.
You weren't in Minerva, perchance, were you?
Well, they give us so many things.
Let's go to our social notes here and find out what's going on. We'll take a look at the lineup this morning. No mug, nothing matters anymore. Yesterday, Beloit fisherman Alex Hawkins turned 8. Lakeview school student, Coventry Township, Kyle Maynard was 10. Paris Mademoiselle, that's Paris, Ohio, Roseanne Morrison was a young 72. Louisville couple, Eileen and George Botchvaroff, celebrated their 51st year together. Well, more power to him. Today, Parma bouncer Kyle Edward McCullough is 1. Cortland boy Ian Hardesty is 2. Happens to be Dorothy Hardesty's grandson. Mm-hmm. Madison second grader Kaylee Klassen is 8. That might be Kylie Klassen, I'm not sure. In Kirtland, Brittany Ann Metelko is having her first breakfast as an 8-year-old. And Cleveland dad Donald Duck Odell is 35, and if you take a close look, his little daughter there, Abigail, is not even slightly impressed. We have ahead of us a sunny day. We're going up to 74. We'll be clear tonight. We'll have a low of 55, and can you believe tomorrow will be sunny and the high is going to be 81. We're 50 at Hopkins. Down at the lakefront, it's 54.
And we'll zip through sports and get you to the mailbag. In sports yesterday, if the Indians and the Red Sox hadn't played the fourth inning, the Tribe might have won the ball game, but the Sox scored 9 runs in their big fourth and won 12-6. On the bright side, Jim Thome hit his 16th homer of the season, and the Indians stole 6 bases, 3 of them by Matt Williams. Now, the Tribe still leading the Central Division by 2.5 games, idle today, and open a series with the Brewers at Jacobs Field tomorrow night. And at Akron, the Arrows pounded the Bay Sox 11-2.
And there was a big basketball game. The Bulls played against Seattle?
No, Utah Jazz.
Utah Jazz. Well, I wasn't paying any attention.
And the series is now tied at 2 games apiece, believe it or not, after the Jazz beat the Bulls 78-73 last night. The Bulls, them Bulls, may be in for a surprise.
Yeah, you forgot totally to mention the golf yesterday.
I didn't forget.
Was that an oversight?
No.
Oh.
Intentional.
Well, at the Kemper Open played at Potomac, Maryland, Mark Wiebe, Mark hadn't won in 11 years. 17 and 18, he missed short putts and gave the tournament to Justin Leonard for his second win. I think everybody was pulling for Wiebe, and he just kind of choked on those two putts.
I watched some of that. I really did.
In Nashville, Dr. Gil Morgan won his second senior event in 2 weeks. That's pretty good stuff. You want it by a couple of strokes. And Pat Hurst took the LPGA event, was played in Michigan. She won it by a stroke by sinking a 20-foot putt on the last hole. And I had a note from Maggie Wright, or a call the other day, and she said, "You guys, the only show in town that told us the regular tour, the seniors, and the women week after week."
And I insisted on that, didn't I? I mean, I said, "Tom, you got to do it.
Take your hand off my shoulder." We're at 6:49 at the breakfast table. We're going to open the mailbag as soon as we come back. This is June the 9th, 1997.
Beautiful morning.
A fatal car crash killed her fiancé.
And I just can't go on. I've tried.
A 911 operator answers her own family's suicide call.
It was my daughter, and she said, send an ambulance.
Now, Joan Rivers shares how she coped with personal tragedy to help other victims survive.
You pull your own life together. You're a great-looking girl. You're a little chubby now. We can knock that off.
Next Saturday.
Monday at 9 on Channel 3.
Brands you know, easy on your pocket. We always got something for the family. At Kohl's we know just how it should be. That's more like it.
If your dad loves Dockers, then you'll love our Father's Day sale prices at Kohl's. Save 30% off all Dockers sports shirts and shorts, and get Dockers original cotton twill pants for just $27.99.
It has the power of 210 turbocharged horses and the agility of four-wheel multi-link suspension. The 1997 Mitsubishi Eclipse GST. It makes waves. The Eclipse Spider, Mirage, and 3000 GT. The family of sports cars from Mitsubishi, built for living.
Are your bills adding up? You're behind on the payments. Do you want to get it under control?
Yes.
No. Do you want to make some home improvements?
Yes.
No. If you're a homeowner and others say no, the door is always open at Advanced Financial Services. Even in the case of bankruptcy, bad credit, or foreclosure, we'll help you consolidate your bills and reestablish your credit. Advanced Financial Services. Call now, 1-800-320-0000. We're here to help 24 hours a day.
My, what big eyes you'll have. Wolf Wilderness at Cleveland Metro Park Zoo.
One sports note we didn't mention, the Browns, the former Browns, returned to Hiram yesterday. Thousands of people went out and got autographs. Brian Sipe was there. Jimmy Brown, a lot of them.
Let me pick some of the lighter things out of our mailbag, and we've been inundated for 2 weeks, and thanks. Karen Malone, who used to be she's the Director of Communications for Columbia Division of Health. I show her St. Vincent Charities. She sent this to me. She said, anybody can do news, but it takes a special person to dance badly each and every morning.
Boy, she gets right to the core of things, doesn't she?
She went right to the chase. Marcia Weirich of Akron, she sent me a letter containing four quarters, and I'm getting all kinds of money this morning. She said, I owe Tom's bank this money due to the letter I wrote to the station.
Uh-oh.
I hope I get to look at it. Jane Miller of Shaker wrote, please blow up Henry and let the little lamb fall off the table.
They didn't do that the last day.
What do we want this week? Yeah. Dorothy Stoke of Loudonville writes, there will never be anything funnier than this sponge cake spot. Dolores Leffler of Richfield, she said, some things she recalls. Reflecting bald head. Nicely combed Clairol hairstyle.
Well, now, where would that be?
Restaurant visits, movie reviews, Christmas tree decorating, milking contest. She's got the whole thing just filled with things like that. Peg Holbert of Montville writes, my cousin gave me an old moonshine jug for a cuss jug. It's not very full, though, because I have to watch my mouth around my daycare kids. Linda Sears of Dundee writes, Tom, take care of that golf game. You could be the oldest Tiger Woods. Del, hope Martha enjoys having you at home. Del's going to be right down here working at the station. I'm going to be on the unemployment line.
But you'll be working.
Roberta Williams of Cleveland writes, I have one request. Your last day, please play Unforgettable with Natalie Cole and her dad, Nat King Cole. See, she thinks we're unforgettable. Well, maybe. George Cheney of Brook Park writes, leave those two silly old men alone and on the air. Signed, signed, a silly old man. Don J. Force, the superintendent of the Green Local Schools. One morning I called Del to tell him that the voice on the Chia Pet commercial sounded suspiciously like the old curmudgeon who destroyed the Chia Pet on camera. Is that possible?
You did that.
Sherry Montalvo of Cleveland writes, Tom, you're not going to retire. I hope you don't. Some opportunity will come up. Love your Irish sarcasm. The station gave that to the paper that I was retiring. That's a crock, but they're not too unfamiliar with crocks. And the Warburton family of Strongsville wrote, thanks for being there on the bad news days, Oklahoma City bombing and the Challenger. We got the news from two television pros who seem more like old friends and good neighbors, reluctantly sharing some troubling information with us. And that's the point, and thanks. And some of the events going on today, Metro RTA begins its North Coast Express, A fun-filled trip from Cleveland to Akron, Monday through Friday through August 22nd. Call 1-800-227-9905. I'll give you the scoop on that. Dr. Carol Zadorozny is going to give a presentation on Alzheimer's disease tonight from 6 to 7 at Marymount Hospital in Garfield Heights. Ooh. And the Western Reserve Historical Society is having a book sale Friday, 5:30 to 8, Saturday, 10 to 5, and Sunday from noon to 3. Back with the weather, a little old passing thought and a recheck of the traffic. 6:54.
There's Joe Wood.
Joe Wood, my buddy, and I'll tell you what, he is a genius up there in the art department. Joe, I love you. For me to fade.
On the next Entertainment Tonight, Julia Roberts' fantasy photo shoot. Only E.T. is behind the scenes as Julia picks out her jewelry, puts on her makeup, and slips into some dazzling dresses. The pretty woman looks pretty amazing, and only E.T. has the poses to prove it.